H.C. Verma, Chapter 6, Question Number 28. Find the acceleration of the block of mass capital M in the situation below. The coefficient of friction between the two blocks is mu 1 and that between the bigger block and the ground is mu 2. Let us assume the acceleration of the bigger block to be A. As you can see, the acceleration of the smaller block with respect to the ground is at some angle with the vertical. Dealing such acceleration is mathematically more complicated. But if we look at the smaller block with respect to the bigger block, then the acceleration of the smaller block is in vertically downward direction. Dealing with such situation is mathematically simpler. But since our frame of reference is now accelerated, a pseudo force must act on the smaller block. Now let us find the relation between the acceleration of the two blocks. If the bigger block moves by distance x towards right, then the length x of a string is freed at both positions, the pulley on the top of the block and the point where the string is attached to the block. This string must be consumed by the smaller block and hence the smaller block must move down by distance 2x. Therefore, if the acceleration of the bigger block is a towards right, the acceleration of the smaller block with respect to the bigger block is 2a in vertically downward direction. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the smaller block. Gravitational force of mg acts on it in vertically downward direction. If we assume the tension in the string to be T, then tension in the string pulls the block upward with force T. Since we are looking at the block with respect to the bigger block which is in accelerated motion, our frame of reference is accelerated and hence pseudo force must act on the block. The magnitude of pseudo force is product of mass of the object into acceleration of the frame and direction is opposite to the direction of the acceleration of the frame. Thus, the pseudo force of M into A acts towards left. Normal contact force between the blocks pushes the block towards right. Let this normal force be N1. Since the block is moving downward, friction force of mu1 times N1 acts in vertically upward direction. The acceleration of the block with respect to the bigger block is 2A. Balancing the forces in horizontal direction, we get N1 is equal to MA. Writing the equation for motion in vertical direction, we get mg minus mu1 n1 minus t is equal to 2ma. Putting the value of n1, we get mg minus mu1 into ma minus t is equal to 2ma, which implies t is equal to mg minus 2 plus mu1 into ma. Now let us make the free body diagram of the bigger block. Gravitational force of capital M into g acts in vertically downward direction. Normal reaction from the floor, say n2, acts in upward direction. Kinetic friction from the floor with magnitude mu2 into n2 acts towards left. The tension in the string T pulls the block towards right. The same string is pulling the pulley. Since the pulley is attached to the block, the forces of the string on the pulley is transferred to the block. Hence at the pulley, tension T pulls the block towards right and the same tension T pulls the block downward. Reaction of the normal contact force between the blocks acts on the bigger block towards left. The reaction of the friction on the smaller block acts on the bigger block in downward direction. The magnitude of this friction is mu1 into n1. Balancing the forces in vertical direction, we get n2 is equal to capital mg plus t plus mu1 n1. Putting the value of tension and n1, we get n2 is equal to capital mg plus mg minus 2 plus mu1 into ma plus mu1 ma. Simplifying, we get N2 is equal to capital Mg plus Mg minus 2ma. Writing the equation for motion of the bigger block in horizontal direction, we get 2t minus N1 minus mu2 N2 is equal to capital Ma. Putting the value of N2, we get 2t minus Ma minus mu2 into capital Mg plus Mg minus 2ma is equal to capital Ma. Putting the value of t, this becomes 2 into mg minus 2 plus mu1 into ma minus ma minus m2 into capital mg plus mg minus 2ma is equal to capital ma. Simplifying, we get 2mg minus 5ma minus 2mu1 ma minus mu2 capital mg minus mu2 mg plus 2mu2 ma is equal to capital ma. Rearranging to keep the terms with g on one side and the terms with a on the other side, we get 2mg minus mu2 into m plus capital M into g is equal to 5ma plus 2mu1 ma minus 2mu2 ma plus capital ma. Or 2m minus mu2 into m plus capital M into g is equal to a into 5m plus 2 into mu1 minus mu2 into m plus capital M. which implies A is equal to 2m minus mu 2 into m plus capital M into g divided by capital M plus m into 5 plus 2 into mu 1 minus mu 2. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from HC Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.